Hello everyone, this is Ashishan. This is another video on detection. Now our next detection is section 80QQB. This section is related to the research work. If an SSE connecting to any kind of research work, or if he or she written some books or publish any book, so the SSE will get some royalty. So royalty will be the income. Now we will see how much amount of deduction he or she will get. Now who will get deduction in this point? Individual, and the individual should be resident. Author of specific book pertaining to these, that is literature, artistic, as well as scientific. Author of specific of these, literature, artistic, and scientific. Now what is the quantum of deduction under this section? First you need to focus in this point, that is eligible royalty. I am not writing here the amount of royalty, I have written eligible royalty, which means first of all we need to find out the amount of eligible royalty. Then we need to compare it with maximum limit of rupees 3 lakh. Then whichever is lower will be deductible amount. Now how to calculate eligible royalty? If the royalty is earned from outside India, amount received in convertible amount convertible foreign exchange within 6 months from the end of relevant previous year will be taken as eligible royalty. Means if an SSE get any amount in the form of royalty in India, then the whole amount will be called eligible royalty. Then we will compare it with 3 lakh. But if the SSE get any amount of royalty from outside India, then the convertible foreign exchange that the SSE got within 6 months, that will be the eligible royalty. Let's take an example. Suppose an SSE got from US royalty amount of rupees 8 lakh, but after convertible foreign exchange he got rupees 2,80,000 only. Now as per the income tax rule, under the PGBP head, the gross amount will be 8 lakh. The gross amount will be 8 lakh. Now suppose he has not any other income, so this will be the GTI, that is rupees 8 lakh. Now he will get a deduction under section 80QQB. How much amount? Maximum amount rupees 3 lakh, and this eligible amount. This eligible amount. Okay, so rupees 3 lakh or rupees 2,80,000, whichever is lower, that will be the amount of deduction. So this will be the amount of deduction, which means 5,20,000 will be the total taxable income. I repeat, first of all we need to get the eligible royalty. Suppose if any SSE get any amount of royalty outside India, then the convertible foreign exchange amount will be the eligible royalty. Then we need to compare it with maximum amount of limit, that is rupees 3 lakh. Whichever is lower will be the deductible amount. Okay. Now if the royalty is on percentage based, then eligible royalty will be maximum 15% of books sold. Maximum 15% of books sold. Now let's take an example of this. Suppose books sold of rupees 30 lakh and he has an agreement with the publisher that he will get 20% of royalty of books sold. Okay, so which means suppose X receiving 20% royalty on 30 lakh, that is rupees 6 lakh. Now the GTI will be rupees 6 lakh and he will get reduction under section 80QQB. Now we need to compare with eligible royalty. The eligible royalty will be 15% of this amount. 15% of this amount, that is rupees 4,50,000 or maximum of rupees 3 lakh, whichever is lower will be the deductible amount. That is, the SSP will get rupees 3 lakh deduction. So the total taxable income will be rupees 3 lakh. So which means, if the royalty is based on percentage book, then the maximum eligibility will be rupees 15% of book sold. Okay. In case of joint author, दो author मिलके एक book publish कर रहे हैं, so in that case the maximum amount rupees 3 lakh will be available for each author. For each author, यहाँ पर देखना each author की बात करना है. क्या मतलब है उसका? Suppose दो person है X and Y. That means each person will get 6 lakh, sorry, the aggregate amount will get rupees 6 lakh. Okay, so this is the section QQB. Now next is section RRB. This section is related to inventor and patent right. देखिए, in this section 80QQB, the deduction is related to the royalty. But here the deduction is related to any kind of invention or any kind of patent right. Who will get this deduction? Only the individual, that is residential individual. Amount of deduction will be again eligibility or maximum amount of rupees 3 lakh, whichever is lower will be the amount of deduction. Now how to calculate an eligibility under this case? Same. If the royalty earned outside India, the amount of received from convertible foreign exchange within 6 months of relevant previous year will be the amount of eligible royalty. Okay. सेम केस आपका सेम 80QQR QQB की तरह, बस ये आपका इन्वेंट्री एंड पेटेंट राइट है, वो आपका पब्लिशन से लेकर है. द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन वी हैव सेक्शन ई सी, दैट इज रेडी टू स्टार्टअप इंडियन फैन. सी यू नो वेरी वेल दैट आर इंडियन गवर्नमेंट आर फोकसिंग ऑन प्रोमोटिंग द स्टार्टअप प्लान. सो टू प्रमोट दिस गवर्नमेंट गिविंग सम रिलैक्सेशन ऑन इनकम टैक्स. So who will get deduction? Company as well as limited liability partnership which must be incorporated between 1st April 2016 to 1st April 2021 and their turnover should be up to 25 crore. I repeat, who will get this deduction? Company or as well as limited liability partnership. And the company should be incorporated between, or the company should be commenced between 1st of April 2016 to 1st of April 2021. and their turnover should not exceed 25 crore. Now, there is a list by the Indian government which tells the about of eligible startup. Okay, aisa nahi hai like eligible startup means there should be something new in their business. Aisa nahi like suppose if I want to do any business related to the sale of or you can say manufacturing of you can say manufacturing of water bottles. So this is not a new something new. So it's eligible startup means there should be something new, which are as per the government's list given, that is there should be some eligible. Okay, and the startup must hold certificate from IMBC, that is Inter Ministerial Board of Certificate, and the amount of deduction will be 100% of profit of 3 consecutive year out of 7 years. That means it is up to the SSE, who will be the SSE company as well as limited liability partnership, that they will get deduction 100% of profit for the 3 consecutive year out of 7 years. Like suppose if you have started a business or startup, aapne start kiya, suppose agar aapne aaj startup kiya, eligible business aapka, so from today onwards 7 years आपके काउंट होंगे फ्रॉम 2020. ठीक है, आपके 7 ईयर्स हैं. आप किसी भी साल में, आप किसी भी लगातार 3 साल में आप जो है इसकी 100% प्रॉफिट की आप डिडक्शन ले सकते हो. नाउ ऑब्वियसली बात है लाइक इफ यू स्टार्टेड सम बिजनेस नाउ, सो यू विल गेट, यू विल नॉट गेट सम दी बट आपका इतना पोटेंशियल बिजनेस नहीं है, सो ऑब्वियसली आपको स्टार्टिंग में लॉस होगा ही होगा. मे बी लॉस में तो प्रॉफिट होगा, इतना नहीं होगा. सो इट्स अप टू यू कि आप जो बिजनेस जो है अपना जो भी प्रॉफिट है वो आप लास्ट में भी कर सकते हो या इन द मिडल ऑफ 7 ईयर्स, जो भी आपके बच्चे 3 साल आप कंसेक्यूटिव ईयर्स में. ओके, सो दिस इज द सेक्शन PSE रेडी टू स्टार्टअप इंडिया लर्न. नाउ द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन वी हैव सेक्शन JJA विच इज रिलेटेड टू बिजनेस ऑफ कलेक्टिंग एंड प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ बायोडिग्रेडेबल. नाउ दिस सेक्शन इज एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल and SSC must be engaged in the business of collecting and processing biodegradable waste for generation of power and proceeding biogas plant. Okay, and the quantum of reduction will be 100% profit from such business for 5 years. So this is very easy. Now we have another section, that is 80GGB and 80GG. ये डिडक्शन किस रिलेटेड है? डिडक्शन इन बैंक मोड टू पोलिटिकल पार्टी और इलेक्टोरल ट्रस्ट. फर्स्ट वी हैव 80GGB. ये किसके लिए? इंडियन कंपनी के लिए. 80GGC किसके लिए है? अदर देन कंपनी और लोकल अथॉरिटी. डोनेशन किस फॉर्म में? कंट्रीब्यूशन या फिर डोनेशन टू पोलिटिकल पार्टी एज और इलेक्ट्रिकल ट्रस्ट ओनली इन बैंक मोड. And the quantum of reduction is 100%. And under section 80GGC, the any kind of contribution or donation to particular party as well as or to electrical trust only in bank mode. Again, in this case, 100% amount of reduction will be here. So actually, I forgot to write one thing here. In this point, the contribution may also include advertisement expenditure. Okay. But in this case, the advertisement expenditure is not included. Okay, that means अगर आप किसी particular party अंदर उसकी advertisement कुछ करना चाहते हैं, खर्चा करना चाहते हो, then you will get deduction under section 80GGB, not only under section 80GGC. Okay. Now next we have, this is very important point from the examination point of view, that is 80 section 80TTA and 80TTB. That means if you, if any SSE is getting any kind of interest of saving banks, FD, RD, so वैसे तो वो किसका पार्ट आता है? इनकम फ्रॉम अदर सोर्सेज, बट गवर्नमेंट गिविंग सम डिडक्शन हियर अंडर 80TTA. हु विल गेट दिस डिडक्शन? इंडिविजुअल HUF जिसकी एज 60 ईयर से कम होना चाहिए, एंड 80DTTB में इंडिविजुअल होना चाहिए, बट यहाँ पर कौन है? ओनली रेजिडेंट. सिर्फ रेजिडेंट की बात करिए यहाँ पर. एंड उसकी एज कितनी होनी चाहिए? 60 ईयर और मोर देन 60 ईयर्स. इस केस में यहाँ पर देखिए इंटरेस्ट ऑन सेविंग्स अकाउंट होना चाहिए, इंटरेस्ट ऑन सेविंग कम डिडक्शन होती है, बट उसका अकाउंट कौन होना चाहिए, एनी इन एनी इंडियन बैंक, इन कोऑपरेटिव बैंक और इन एनी पोस्ट ऑफिस। बट इन द केस ऑफ ATTDB इंटरेस्ट ऑन सेविंग अकाउंट मिल रही है, FD भी मिल रही है, रिकरिंग डिपॉजिट में मिल रही है, अगर उसका अकाउंट इंडियन बैंक में है, कोऑपरेटिव बैंक में है या फिर पोस्ट ऑफिस में, सब में उसको रिडक्शन मिलेगी। यहाँ पर क्वांटम रिडक्शन कितनी है 10,000, यहाँ पर क्वांटम रिडक्शन कितनी है 50,000। सो दिस इज द ऑल अबाउट द 80 सेक्शन TTA एंड TTB। सो दिस इज द ऑल अबाउट द डिडक्शन चैप्टर। आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड वेरी वेल। थैंक यू।